1891 must have been a busy year for Francis. Seems an ambitious expedition. Like father, like son. Now, that kid looks a little familiar. Curious craftsmanship. These must be worth a fortune. I'm looking sharp, but I guess that's the point.
I had some questions about Bethany.
I beg your pardon. I don't believe I know anyone of that name.
Well, it came up during the investigation. See, your father divorced, and his ex-wife's name was Bethany.
Say no more. It is beyond my earliest memories. But even if it weren't, my father's business is his own. I shall not engage in gossip.
Your father led an expedition back in 1891. Do you know anything about it?
I'm not the best person to ask, I'm afraid. I was a babe in arms back then, and my father never made his findings public. It is a great shame, of course. His work would have turned the science of evolution on its head.
Yeah, I can see that. Have a good day. looking for Bethany Throgmorton. You got any patients by that name?
We'd know if we had a Throgmorton. Although, we do have a Bethany. Or rather, we did. She's missing. And not on one of her usual walks.
Her usual walks? You let patients leave the building?
Oh, Bethany was harmless, and she always came back. This time, well, I've never known her to be like that.
You mean she broke out?
Yes, knocked an orderly out cold. She was out the door in a moment. It took us all by surprise. She's usually harmless.
Any idea where she went?
No. She had been odd recently, though. Muttering to herself, and she drew this strange picture on her bedroom wall.
That's interesting. Can I take a look at her room?
I suppose it couldn't hurt. She had a separate room downstairs. Here's the key, but do watch out for broken glass.
Bye. The blood's almost dry.
Haven't you seen the beast? Watch your pocket. Some patients here have wandering fingers.
Just stare at my leaves.
Let's play.
The end is nigh. It will begin again. What is down comes up. The seed is sowed.
Can you hear? Somebody singing. Beautiful. Beautiful. Can you hear it?
What can I do for you?
At 7 years each, that's a lot of bad luck.
I'm glad it's not mine. Someone had a field day defacing these. Huh. Was this taken at gunpoint?
I will find it, baby boy. I promise. Just tell me more. I will find it, baby boy. I promise. Just tell me more.
There's enough dope left in here to knock out a horse.
Stop.
You no longer have any power over me. I have found my Hammond. He's shown me the way. Randall Glassworks in Salvation Harbor. Oh, I can't believe it. The answers have been there since last century.
Time to piece this one together.
Randall Glassworks. You no longer have any power.
Stop right there.
Bethany escaped the asylum after getting the mirror from Glover. Next stop looks to be a factory called Randall Glassworks. Seems that Bethany had a thing for mirrors. You know anything about that?
Oh, yes. Poor soul. She was convinced there was a boy called Hammond living in her mirrors. She talked to him every day.
I see. Bye.
Thank you. extra, extra. All the news that's fit to print.
Buy a paper, mister?
All the news that's fit to print.
cheaper than the rest.
Yes, yes, I haven't got all day. What do you want?
Just wanted to say hi. I'm new in town.
Oh, how nice for you. If you need to look anything up in our archives, get in line like everybody else.
Well, if that's the way it is, then that's the way it is.
Good. I'm glad we understand each other.
Bye.
Extra.
Thank you. Fresh fish. Just caught, mister.
Looks like this workbench was used for making frames. Some sort of treatment solution. It must be what they use to turn glass panes into mirrors.
A human face. Hold up, I'll unlock the door. I guess you're the reason that beast in the basement went quiet. I don't know how to thank you, mister.
Well, for a start, have you seen an old lady with a mirror around here?
Huh. Old Bethany? Of course. She got locked in our storage downstairs when the beasts attacked. I got a spare key. Please let her out. And feel free to take any supplies you want. You saved our lives.
All in a day's work. Thanks.
This used to be an okay place to live.
Do all mirror makers look this shifty? Nice work. It looks like the craftsman's gone out of business, though. Too bad. Who knew that so much planning went into mirrors?
They hide underwater.
In the pools, in the puddles. Can't be too careful.
His house? Randall's house? Hold on, Hammond. We're almost there.
It's a thick book. Thick enough to be someone's life's work. Someone's been stocking up.
Thank you.
These have been here a while.
Extra, extra. All the news that's fit to print. Buy a paper, mister.
These have been here a while. Where does one find a miniature coffin like this? Where does one find a miniature coffin like this? Where does one find a miniature coffin like this? Father proud. Life can be cruel. Life can be cruel.
Hey! Hey, let me out! Hey, let me out!
Biggest mirror exhibition in the history of Oakmont, including Master Randall's finest creations. And the biggest mirror exhibition in the history of his manor into a museum of vintage mirrors collected over many decades. Somebody's been doing their homework.
There. As long as this mirror stays whole, you will be safe, baby boy. Safe, while I find a way to free you. I will get you out, Hammond. There has to be a way. These rites, they might buy me time.
Time to piece this one together.
These rites, they might buy me time. There. As long as this mirror stays whole, you will be safe, baby boy. Safe. While I find a way to free you. I will get you out, Hammond. There has to be a way. I will get you out, Hammond. There has to be a way. These rites, they might buy me time. There. As long as this mirror stays whole, you will be safe, baby boy. Safe, while I find a way to free you.
Bethany set up some sort of barrier to buy time while she tries to free Hammond. I could remove it by destroying her ritual mirror.
no, no. You can't have him. I won't let you. You can't take the mirror. You hear me?
Bethany, calm down, please. I mean you no harm.
No, you won't take my child. Not again. I won't let you.
It's okay. We can talk about this. I know the mirror is important to you.
It's my son. My son. His soul, his very being trapped in the mirror. Cold, hungry, scared for decades. It's... Kay, it's so hard to understand. His body is dead, but his soul is frozen in glass, unable to move on or return without help. Oh, Francis thought this was merciful. Oh, the wretch.
What do you mean to do then?
I can call Hammond back into his own body. Don't judge me. This may seem unnatural, but we will be together. Everything is ready. I'm sure it will work. I only need to break the mirror to release him.
I can't go back empty-handed.
And I won't leave without my son.
Okay. Well, I guess you've got the right to try. Go ahead. I'll have to find some way to sweet-talk Robert.
Oh, thank you. Oh, thank you so much. Newcomer, you made the right choice.
Life can be cruel.
Oh, thank you so much, newcomer. You made the right choice.
Thank you.
I was too late. The mirror. I found it broken.
What? No. How? How could this happen? Oh, my brother, my poor brother. I expected better from you, Mr. Reed. By gay, I did. Drock, just go. Leave me to my ghosts. I'm not in the mood for chit-chat, Mr. Reed.